What you're holding is the very first artistic interpretation of the darkness. Or as it was known then, he who comes with the night. Not the catchiest of names, but pretty good when you consider that most people are still living in caves. Anyway, at this point in history, Cain, you know, Adam's son, as in the Garden of Eden, first guy to ever walk the earth, Adam, had dealt with most of the demons and assorted nasties that still roam the world. But no one had faced the darkness yet. See, God protected Cain from the darkness by making him unkillable. It was a great plan. If you happen to be Cain, everyone else, not so much. Murder didn't stop just because Cain ran out of brothers to bludgeon, so the darkness still had plenty of souls to latch onto. Some legends suggest the darkness was first carried by a son of Lilith. Others say it was a Nephilim, but I don't buy that one. We'd all be dead if that was the case. Not that it matters. Okay, whoever was, through him, the darkness raped, ravaged, and generally fucked things up. Only the Angelus had the power to face the darkness. All Cain could do was warn people. So he sculpted 12 of these statues, entrusting them to 12 holy men. They carried these statues across the land, spreading word of he who comes with the night. But the darkness did not want to be known. Within a year, it had devoured all 12 of them. The statues were gone, shattered, or lost to time. Well, until now, apparently.